The last 365 days for Concord Athletics have been filled with unforgettable moments, from records being broken to storybook careers concluding, and from milestone moments and victories being achieved to outstanding plays in the most dramatic fashion. 2023 for Concord saw the resurgence of a couple of programs and a mid-season rebound for another. We take a look back at the top 10 storylines and moments from the calendar year.
Number 10. This year saw two new head coaches begin their tenure as the head coaches for Concord programs. In January, Alex Smith was named coach of the men's soccer team and was tasked with leading a program looking for the first conference postseason appearance in more than two decades. And after three seasons on the sidelines as Concord's offensive coordinator, Brian Ferguson was tabbed the 21st head football coach in program history.
And I'm going to require our players to be champions on the football field and in the classroom. And my whole goal is to not only develop them as champions on the football field or in the classroom, but teach these guys and develop these guys to be champions in life.
Number 9. One thing can be certain in the year-end countdown, a spot reserved for the cross-country programs. In November, Logan Zucchelli of the men's cross-country team qualified for the NCAA Division II National Championship by earning all-region for the third consecutive year. And his qualification to the national meet marked the seventh straight year of a Concord men's cross-country athlete making the NCAA Division II championship. Also in November, Emily Wallace closed out her exceptional cross-country career with a third straight all-region performance. Wallace is the only multi-time all-region athlete in program history.
Number 8. The fall season saw the return of success for Concord volleyball and the men's soccer team go to new heights. It had been six seasons since the Mountain Lion volleyball team had smelled the conference tournament, and 7 years since a winning season had been accomplished. Both were checked off. Picked to finish last in the Mountain East Conference South Division, the volleyball team finished with a record of 16-15, and third in the MEC South with a youthful roster of 11 freshmen. The future appears bright for head coach Kate Dillon and company, with only three seniors. On the pitch, Smith used a mixture of transfers and returning players to quiet the doubters as Concord was picked last in the MEC preseason poll. The Mountain Lions made the ascent to finish fourth in the MEC and recorded the second most wins in program history with eight for the first-year head coach.
Number 7. The men's and women's basketball teams picked up wins over nationally ranked teams to begin their seasons. The men's basketball program made a splash on the opening night of the season on November 10th. As it grinded out a 61-57 win over 4th-ranked IUP on the Crimson Hawks home court. The win has helped Concord to its best start in 8 years, as CU is 7-1 at the Christmas break. Head coach Tesla Southcott and the women's basketball team continued to solve the stifling full-court pressure of West Virginia State, as the Mountain Lions recorded a 70-57 win November 21st over the then nationally ranked 13th Yellow Jackets. It was the 11th win for Concord over West Virginia State in the last 14 tries.
Number 6. One of the top two most prolific quarterbacks in program history left his mark in the maroon and gray during his final season. Jack Mangle, a 30-plus game starter, broke Brian Novak's passing touchdown record in late September with his 72nd career passing touchdown at Wheeling. Mangle finished his career with 81 passing touchdowns, which also ranks third in MEC history. Mangle concluded his time at Concord ranked either first or second in program history in touchdowns, yards, completions, and attempts.
Number 5. Perhaps no one had a more dramatic moment and play for Concord in 2023 than Nikayla Gray of the women's basketball team, as she and her teammates lived in the madness of March. With the final seconds counting down and her team trailing by 3 points in the Mountain East Conference Tournament quarterfinals versus West Virginia State.
Alantanchi guarding her. They work it in. They try to work it underneath. The ball comes out. 3 seconds. Three to tie. It's good. A three by Nikayla Gray ties it up. With 1 second to go, CZ Russell fires it up. Half court. And it's off the rim. We are going to overtime.
The Mountain Lions would go on to defeat West Virginia State in overtime to spring the upset in the conference tournament, and Gray would secure her spot in MEC history by winning MEC Play of the Year for the 2022-23 academic year.
Number 4. We have more dramatic plays and storylines at number 4. Already with a satisfying season under their belt, the men's soccer team was seeking more history in their first ever conference tournament home game against West Virginia Wesleyan in the MEC quarterfinals. Both teams would score in the first half, and deep into the second half is where the real theater began. Concord scored in the 75th minute, but Wesleyan came back with a goal less than a minute later. Now into overtime and penalty kicks appearing imminent.
In the penalty area, Amhoff back to Dwight Savory with 60 seconds remaining until kicks. Andre Nicholson, and it's Concord! Oh my goodness! Andre Nicholson!
And what was the first conference tournament win in program history and the program's first conference tournament appearance in 22 years.
Number three. Appearing to be down and out after a 4-12 start to the season, the Concord baseball team needed a lift. A coaching change would take place, putting longtime and recently retired head coach Kevin Garrett back into the dugout. A 17-1 record to begin conference play got the season back on track as Concord went on to finish the year at 29-21 and was one of three teams remaining at the MEC tournament. Among the honors for the Mountain Lions were Garrett being named MEC Coach of the Year and Andrew Neff being selected MEC Pitcher of the Year while leading a slim pitching staff. Neff set single season program records in wins with 12 and strikeouts with 95. And in total, 10 Concord players were voted to the All-MEC teams.
Number two, Isaac Prather wrote the final chapter of his illustrious career in 2023. The multi-time All-American in both cross-country and track and field was named MEC Track Athlete of the Year during both the indoor and outdoor seasons and was also voted All-Region in multiple events during the two track seasons. He set five school records during his final year of eligibility. In his final 3,000-meter steeplechase, Prather ran to a first-team All-American performance, something he had yet to capture on the oval. Prather added to his two second-team All-American titles in track and his first-team All-American honor from 2021 in cross-country.
Number one. For the third time since 2019, the women's soccer program tops the countdown. Needing to replace a host of scoring from the previous two seasons, head coach Luke Duffy's squad leaned on a group of youthful Mountain Lions to earn the program's third NCAA tournament bid in the last four seasons. 11 different players scored at least three goals, headed by Sydney Tucker with 12 goals, who had never scored at Concord in her previous two seasons. The veteran leadership of Olivia Bekaleski, Michelle Brogdon, and Rihanna Cook played a steady hand in the midfield, and a retooled defensive unit recorded 8 shutouts. Despite being knocked out in the NEC tournament semifinals, the regular season resume was good enough for Concord to advance to the NCAA tournament at Kutztown, where the Mountain Lions were clipped by the Bears 3-2. That's a look back at the best of the best of 2023. We hope you have enjoyed the top 10 moments in the last 365 days. Here's to a great and successful 2024 for the Mountain Lions. Thanks for watching.